Hi, in this video I will show you the new features of the Virtual Media Keyboard for Unreal Engine 5.1. First, we need to create a new project and add the Virtual Media Keyboard project to it. Let's name it Media Keyboard Test, for example. Also, you can use your own settings for this project, it doesn't matter for the ending result. If you have created a project and you need simply to add the Virtual MIDI keyboard, follow the steps after launching the newly created project. It is important to enable the required plugins. So, after the project is loaded, we need to choose in the main menu, Edit, and then Plugins. And type there MIDI. After that, enable the MIDI device support plugin. To enable the settings, we need to restart the engine by pressing the button Restart Now at the bottom right corner. After restarting the engine, we can see what happened in the content browser. There we have the folder content, and there in the folder content we need to create another folder which will be named like MIDI Keyboard Test. Also there we'll add the folder named Amps, and there we will create the new level, which will be like MTLL, and we will save all changes. The map will save it in the folder maps, and let's save it like starter. Also, let's make this level like default launch map. Let's go to the Edit and Project Settings, and there in the tab Maps and Modes, and change default maps to the starter map. After this, let's save all and exit the project. In the next step, we need to go to the library, add the Epic Game Launcher and add the Virtual MIDI Keyboard project to our newly created project. If you have an early created project, the way to add the MIDI Virtual Keyboard to it is the same. Let's type Virtual MIDI into the valid text field and the Virtual MIDI Keyboard project icon will appear. Then press Add to the project button, and after that we need to choose the project to which we need to add the Virtual MIDI Keyboard project. After then, we can launch the project. The Virtual MIDI Keyboard project folder will appear in Content Browser. Into level, we need to add the blueprint of the Virtual MIDI Keyboard. To do this, let's open the Virtual MIDI Keyboard folder, then open the blueprint folder, and there we can find the BP underscore Virtual MIDI Keyboard blueprint, which we need to drop to our level. And let's create the point light to illuminate our scene. The Virtual MIDI keyboard is a MIDI visualization tool from Unreal Engine 5.1 version, added a new feature assigning the meta sounds to keys. The meta sound is assigned as a sound generator. In case we need to connect the Unreal Engine to other software like digital audio workstation or audio visualization software for projection mapping, for example, we can use the Loop MIDI software to create a virtual MIDI device connection. The software is available to download from an official website, which you can find below in the description of this video. After installing, we need to create additional virtual MIDI ports. In this video, we create two additional virtual MIDI ports with the names Loop MIDI Port 1 and Loop MIDI Port 2. Let's see the parameters of the virtual MIDI keyboard blueprint in the Details panel. Press the Edit in Blueprint, and where the Print to Screen information area is, find the Print String node and increase duration to 15. Then compile and save the blueprint. When we run the simulation or a standalone game, we will see the list of available MIDI devices. That's why we increase the time of appearing on the list, just to see which MIDI ports are available on the machine. Now we have 15 seconds to overview it. The MIDI ports that we use in this video are first 10 and 11. The 10 and 11 MIDI ports are the Loop MIDI ports that we create in the Loop MIDI software, and these MIDI ports need to connect Unreal Engine with other software, Digital Audio Workstation as an example. The real MIDI keyboard available in this case, and on which I will create some MIDI events, is Arturia KLab Essentials 88. And if we set the parameters to the first MIDI port in the MIDI input device ID, it means in this case that we will play with the Arturia KLab Essentials 88 MIDI keyboard. By changing the audio volume multiplier parameter, you can adjust the overall volume of the sound. In this case, we will set it to 0, which is the mute position, and we will use the MIDI port to generate the sound in another way. If we run the simulation this time, nothing we hear while we're playing. It happened because we need to assign the right MIDI output port to generate the sound. Let's change it to 0 MIDI port, which is Microsoft MIDI Mapper. So, now we hear the playing of the piano via Microsoft MIDI Mapper, which is the default Windows MIDI sound generator. Let's set now the MIDI output device to 10, which is Loop MIDI 1 MIDI port, and try to send the MIDI events to the Digital Audio Workstation. In this example, we will use the Ableton Live Digital Audio Workstation to generate the sound. First, set the parameters right in Ableton Live. The MIDI keyboard that it used for playing in Unreal Engine needs to be disabled in Ableton Live. Go to Options, Preferences, and in Link, Tempo, and MIDI tab, disable the MIDI input ports that is used in Unreal. Leave the Loop MIDI ports on because we will use it to receive MIDI events to Ableton Live from Unreal. Let's assign the instrument. I will use the Arturia Analog Lab in this case and change the instrument to the piano German Classical Clean. Set the Loop MIDI port 1 in the MIDI from drop-down list and check the In button in the monitor section. After that, you can receive the MIDI to Ableton and work directly there to set up your own instruments and sound performance. Unreal Engine will visualize all playing on the real MIDI keyboard at the virtual MIDI keyboard. Another way is to send the MIDI events from digital audio workstation to Unreal Engine. In this case, we will use the Bitwig digital audio workstation. This is a simple project with several tracks. The first two are sending MIDI over the Loop MIDI port 1 and Loop MIDI port 2. The way to send the MIDI events from Bitwig is to assign the hardware instrument and set the correct MIDI out in a drop-down list. In Unreal, I create two virtual MIDI cables with different MIDI input device ID assigned. These ports we will use to receive the MIDI events from Bitwig. While we start the simulation, we can check the right numbers of the ports in a list and also check the connected port in the right top corner of the virtual MIDI keyboard. The upper keyboard is connected to Loop MIDI port 2 and the bottom to Loop MIDI port 1. Let's play the sequence at the Bitwig and look at the results in Unreal. This is the basic principle to send, receive and visualize playing on a piano or keyboard in virtual MIDI keyboard in Unreal. Thanks for watching this video. Press the like button, comment or subscribe to my channel to follow the news from all our Unreal projects that are available in Unreal Marketplace. See you in the next videos.